Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Anjini Devi, Associate Professor, Department of Biotechnology, Vignan's Foundation for Science, Technology and Research. I'm taking up the course Enzyme Technology for third year BTech Biotech students. Today, in this session, we are going to learn about principles of catalysis. That means we are going to learn about two theories, nothing but collision theory as well as transition state theory. The first one is your collision theory. First, you need to know who have proposed this collision theory and what this collision theory explains you and more about collision theory. So, collision theory was proposed individually, independently by Trout as well as Lewis. This collision theory explains us about chemical reaction, how this chemical reaction occurs and why reaction rates differs from one reaction to the another, why different reactions are having different reaction rates. And now we have to learn what is reaction rate. A reaction rate is nothing but the measure of formation of product over time. According to this collision theory, a chemical reaction occurs when this reacting particles collide with one another. That means they should come and collide with one another. So, can you explain whether all the collisions will be resulting into fruitful chemical reactions? No. Only a portion, a fraction of collisions between particles will be resulting in fruitful chemical reactions. Then, what are the various criteria that are required for a fruitful chemical reaction? The first and foremost criteria for a fruitful chemical reaction is nothing but the correct orientation of the reactants. When the reactants are coming to collide with one another, they should orient in a proper way. If they collide in a proper orientation, then only it will be resulting in a fruitful chemical reaction. When the two reactants are colliding in an improper orientation, a fruitful chemical reaction will not take place. What are the other important criteria for fruitful chemical reactions? The second important criteria is nothing but sufficient activation energy. Now, for a chemical reaction to take place, the reactant molecules must also collide with sufficient amount of energy, which is nothing but activation energy. Now, what is activation energy? It is represented by capital A and small a. Activation energy is the minimum amount of collision energy required to initiate a chemical reaction. This collision energy depends upon the kinetic energy of the colliding particles. And now, what is the amount of activation energy that you require for a fruitful chemical reaction? This activation energy should overcome this electrostatic repulsion forces that are present between the two reacting molecules, as well as they should weaken the bonds present between the reactants. The bonds may be ionic bonds or covalent bonds. So, the amount of activation energy required is used for weakening the bonds that are present between the reactants. And what are the other important criteria for a fruitful chemical reaction? So, very important factor is surface area of the reactants. For example, if you are considering a reactant molecule with a large surface area, then the probability of collisions are more. If you are considering reactants with smaller surface area, there is less probability of successful collisions. Another factor is nothing but the concentration of reactant. So if you consider reactant in high concentration, then the probability of collisions are more. When you are considering reactants in low concentration, the probability of collision is less. Then another important criteria is nothing but temperature. If you provide an ample temperature, an ample amount of temperature, or if you provide increased temperature, then the particles will be gaining more amount of energy. They will be moving very fastly. They will move very rapidly and collide with one another. That means at high temperatures, the probability of collisions are more when compared to low temperature. And the last criteria is nothing but the presence of catalyst. In the presence of catalyst, the reaction will be carried out very fastly. This catalyst increases the number of successful collisions by lowering the activation energy. So, learn more about what I have explained you till now from this video.
Collision theory on bond formation and reaction rates. The collision theory explains why chemical reactions occur and the rate at which they occur. The reaction time of a chemical reaction is how fast the chemical reaction occurs. When we talk about collisions, we refer to particles crashing into one another to break bonds. Bonds form between atoms that are held together by opposite charges. How does this affect a chemical reaction? The theory states that some collisions are effective and some are ineffective. Just because particles in a reaction collide does not necessarily mean that they will react. Particles must collide with sufficient kinetic energy to form a successful product. In order to break existing bonds to create new bonds for the product, the reaction must have enough activation energy. Activation energy is the required energy needed for a reaction to occur. For example, in order for a large rock to roll down a hill, the person must first put in enough energy to get the rock over the bump. A chain reaction occurs once the product begins to form. If the concentration and/or the temperature is great enough, it will increase the speed of the particles, which is directly related to the increase in collisions. This results in a faster reaction rate by decreasing the activation energy. Finally, let's take a look at two types of bonding. Covalent and ionic. Covalent bonds occur when electrons are being shared. For example, the two fluorine atoms each share one electron to form a covalent bond. Rather than sharing, ionic bonds transfer electrons, either by giving one or taking one. Sodium chloride, NaCl, is a common example. We're all familiar with table salt. The sodium atom gives an electron to the chlorine atom, causing an ionic bond to occur, with salt as the product.
Now, we will move towards another theory, that is nothing but transition state theory. We have to first learn who are the people who have proposed this theory. It's nothing but Ehrens as well as Polanyi. They have worked simultaneously in order to give you this transition state theory. They have studied on quantum mechanics. Then, while studying quantum mechanics, they have proposed this theory. So, this theory, this transition state theory is also referred to as activated complex theory, absolute rate theory, and theory of absolute reaction rates. When the reactant molecules collide with the required amount of activation energy, they will form an activated complex before the formation of a product. That means, just consider a reaction. Two reactants are coming together. Okay. So, as we know that we will be always saying that the reactants will collide with one another certain amount of the energy, and ultimately they will be leading towards the formation of product. But we have to know that before a product is formed, there is a formation of an intermediate stage, which is nothing but transition state. And this activated complex is formed in this transition state. According to this theory, a transition state is existing between the reactants as well as the products. The state in which this activated complex is formed is known as transition state. The theory assumes a special type of chemical equilibrium called as quasi-equilibrium between the reactants and activated transition state complexes. Next, we have to learn about what are the characteristics of an activated complex. So, first and foremost thing is, this activated complex that is formed as an intermediate stage, that is between the reactants as well as the product, this activated complex is highly unstable and it will be having very short lifespan. And the potential energy of this activated complex is very high when compared to the reactants and products. In an activated complex, the bonds in the reactant molecules are in the process of breaking while the new bonds in the product molecules are starting to form. The activated complex of these reactants are in chemical equilibrium. Means it decomposes to form products or reactants. Sometimes this after this transition state, may lead towards the formation of a product, or sometimes it may revert back to reactants. Just see this figure. From this figure, you can say that this substrate molecules are present at the ground state. After retaining certain amount of energy, which is called as activation energy, the molecules, this reactant molecules, are going towards the transition state. In this transition state, if you observe, the highest amount of activation energy is present. After that, gradually there is loss of activation energy, and again the products will be formed. Now, we have to learn about what are the postulates of transition state theory. There are three important postulates. There are three important factors that determine whether a reaction will occur or not. The first and foremost thing is the concentration of the activated complex. The concentration of the activated complex. And the second one is the rate at which this activated complex break apart. And the third one is the mechanism by which the activated complex breaks apart. It can be either by converting into product, or it can revert back to reactants. Now, we can see the difference between the collision theory and the transition state theory. Upon considering the nature, the collision theory is only for the reaction involving gaseous reactants, whereas transition state theory can be applied to reactions taking place in solutions as well as the gas phase. Coming to the next criteria, the chemical reactions occurs when molecules collide with sufficient amount of kinetic energy in the case of collision theory. In the case of this transition state theory, in between the state where molecules are reactants and the state where molecules are product, there is a state known as transition state. Coming to the principle of this theory, collision theory states that chemical reactions occurs due to collision between reactants, whereas transition state theory states that chemical reactions occurs by going through transition state. And what are the requirements? According to this collision theory, only successful collisions causes chemical reaction to take place. According to transition state theory, a chemical reaction will progress if the reactants can overcome the activation energy barrier. So, until now, we have learned about collision theory, transition state theory, and the differences between these two. I want you people to go through these links in order to gain more knowledge about this topic. And please work out on these questions to assess yourself and gain more information. Thank you.